Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another edition of AGP Unboxed. Today we're going to be taking a look at Oniwaban from the Yujing Army from the Infinity game. Very, very cool looking miniature, very characterful pose. Really excited about getting into this thing. There's not a whole lot as far as packaging that we can look at other than the stat card that you're looking at right now. So let's just jump in and I'll show you exactly what is in this blister pack. Alright, your standard inspection card, and let's see here, there we go. So you got this fairly well done stat card. I like these things because they really emphasize the model. You got a couple of different ways to go when you can do pictures of your miniatures. You can go all model, you can do model or terrain, model within terrain, or you can kind of halfway do both of them and it doesn't look good. But this is really a good example of just showing off the model itself. You got a really nice contrasting background with the miniature. The model itself stands out very, very nicely. So let's jump in and see what is in the blister. We've got the model itself, we've got a base, and we've got a couple of arms and a sword. Alright, now let's see here. Where would that go? Oh, that's the sheath for the sword. Now, alright. Standard slot of base style miniature fits into the base with no cleanup whatsoever. I'm looking here. I can see a few mold lines. Let me see if I can zoom in, kind of make that a little bit more visible for you. There we go. You see that line? I hope you can already see it without me having to point to it. That line that runs right there down the miniature's leg, and then this line right up here on the thigh of the miniature. Very shallow looking mold lines, but they are visible, which is good. It makes the cleanup process a lot easier. On the right hand side of the miniature, you've actually got what appears to be a double mold line. The mold looks like it actually breaks over this fold right here, because I can see a really harsh mold line on the edge of this fold going down the thigh. But there's also a mold line running through this little pack right here. Let me kind of turn it so you can see it. There we go, running slightly through that pack and down over the knee. And again, kind of tough to see with the light glaring onto it. Trying to get the light to catch it just right. You can kind of see it right there, the little hint of white line that runs just over the knee right there. So again, mold lines are not that bad. Not that difficult, or I can't imagine they would be very difficult to get rid of. The model itself is fairly open, so you could easily get a hobby knife into a lot of these places, and a small file will fit into the majority of the rest of them. Now, you can see the position of the feet. For the most part, at least in my version, the model does sit flat, which is good. A little bit of cleanup going to be involved in the base to get the model to sit flat once it's on the base. Otherwise, you're going to have this peg sticking out. But other than that, really nice. Just a few pieces of flashing that I see on the miniature. You see that big piece that's sticking out right there on the arm. Tiny bit here on the model's right arm there. Just a little piece right there on the edge. All right, so let's see here. We've got the sword here, or a sword, and let's see here. That's going to obviously connect into this arm, which I can't put it in there right now because I've got that little piece of flash on the back side right there. I'm slightly concerned about that piece of flashing right there. The end of the sword is right there where my knife is. So everything past that is all flashing. Now, that may not seem like a huge deal, except for the fact that I can tell you that the model itself as a whole, especially this piece of the sword right here, is very thin and kind of flimsy. So I'm going to have to be careful in removing that. I might have to remove it with a pair of sprue cutters or something, even though I hate using sprue cutters on metal because it dulls the blade out, but I'll come up with something and put it together, and hopefully it'll look nice there. The other hand of the model should just slip right into place. It appears to be anyway. Let me make sure. Yeah, it is. Okay, you can see, hopefully anyway, there is, it helps hold it sideways. it's almost a three-piece section here. You've got a flat section right there. You've got a flat section right there. And you've got a flat section on this side right here. So you've got basically three flat sections going into a point. So you're looking at essentially the top of a pyramid, instead of it being just a circle or a nice flat area here on the shoulder. Now what that does is it corresponds with this sort of triangular section on the inside of the arm right here. And so your miniature will pretty much, unless you do some conversion work, all the models are pretty much going to look exactly identical, but that's okay. What it does do, especially, is it assists in making the model easier to put together, because you know exactly how that arm's going to go on there. You don't have to worry about getting into the wrong position, or a position that's not going to look, quote-unquote, correct. Okay, so pretty cool stuff there. And then the last piece here we have is the scabbard of the sword. And I see a tiny, tiny little peg here on the edge of the scabbard. Let me see if there's a corresponding hole in the miniature. I don't think there is. I don't remember seeing one. Let's see. Oh, it would help if I looked in the right spot. Okay, great. So, yep. Okay, there we go. Good. So, there's a tiny, tiny little hole right there on the side of the model that little peg should slip into. All right, now I may have to chop that peg off and figure out some other way to get it to stay in there, because the peg actually looks quite large. But this piece fits on there sort of like so. So it's going to be kind of an odd three-dimensional section of the piece that just sort of sticks out like this. To be honest with you, I may leave that off. Not really sure. It's an odd piece. It doesn't necessarily fit with the rest of the miniature. I may actually put it, let's see here. I might put it up there. Going more across the back, I'd have to come up with some sort of like a shoulder strap or something for it. But anyway, very nice model. The detail on the miniature is very, very good. I love this transitionary area. I don't know if you can see it, but you've got these very, very cool transitions from what appears to be armor to some sort of alien skin. It's just these really harsh transitions from incredibly smooth armor to, well, for lack of a better term, think of like James Cameron's Aliens, like the walls and things like that inside the alien nest. That's sort of what the skin on this guy looks like. Very, very unique style miniature. Very cool, though. I like this guy a lot. Anyway, I think that's going to be it for this unboxing. I'm not going to go ahead and put the guy together right now because I've got a whole lot of other stuff sitting on the desk. Ready to be painted, and so this guy will have to kind of take a back seat for a while, but he will get painted up over the next couple of months, because I do like this guy. He's a very, very cool model. Anyway, as far as a score, taking into the account the amount of cleanup that's probably going to be involved, putting the model together, which again, haven't done yet, but I imagine a couple of pins up here where the sword goes. Oh, pardon me. Perhaps a pin in this arm as well, and then trying to figure out what to do with that scabbard shouldn't be too difficult at all. And I'm looking at the guy, trying to see if there's going to be any difficult spots to paint, which I cannot imagine that there would be. It looks so smooth that I really doubt there's going to be any difficulty in the painting process whatsoever. So I think overall score for this guy, pretty impressive miniature. Not the best model that I've ever seen, but it's an intriguing model. And so because of that, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to give him maybe somewhere between a 7 and an 8. Maybe a 7.5 out of 10. I think that's pretty reasonable for this guy. It's not one of those models that you're going to go out and go, wow, that's the greatest model on the planet. But it does have some nice little details. It's got a good bit of character to the miniature. And it's just a fun model. Sort of one of those middle-of-the-road miniatures that you may pass up if you just saw it in a store and weren't actually looking for something or looking for it to fit in your army or something like that. So it's kind of one of those models, but it's still a really, really nice piece. So again, overall score of about 7.5 out of 10 on this guy. Anyway, I think that's going to be it for this episode of AGP Unboxed. I really appreciate you guys watching. Thank you very, very much. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.